R.I. Presents.
Sea people, mountain people, erosion. Continued last time. Ryoji left the inn and headed for a cave search, but before that, he visited the museum of the Hokuto ruins. He then parked the car in the parking lot of the observatory and walked to the exploration site. Then, when he arrived at the search site, he climbed over the guardrails and headed for the hills. This is Kushiro Marsh, even if it is on the edge. He didn't know where the mud was, so he walked carefully and proceeded to the foot of the hill, looking at the surrounding conditions and his underfoot. When he reached the foot of the hill, he paused for a moment and looked up at the hill. He thought it might be a little different, but he immediately started going up the hill. I wonder if it's a little low. While muttering, he climbed up looking around so as not to overlook it, but arrived at the top without being able to find anything. Then looked around, thinking it wouldn't be easy to find it right away. Then, a short distance from where he found a series of hills higher than this hill. The surrounding area was dotted with trees, which was different from the hill he had imagined, but he had assumed it. He thought he couldn't stay slow, so he looked around and headed for the next hill. When he reached the foot of the next hill, he began to climb, looking at the surroundings as well, but on his way he remembered the presence of guardrails and looked for guardrails that should have been visible from near the top of the hill. Then, the presence of the guardrail was confirmed in the back by the middle of the hill. It resembles the scene he remembered. Feeling something convincing, he then moved sideways up the hill to explore his surroundings. Then, a short distance away, he found a place where the soil was bare. When he approached the place, it was a little hollow, and when he got closer, he shouted in surprise, "There it is!" The hole when he got out of the cave appeared in front of him. He approached the hole, crouched down slowly, unloaded his backpack off his back, and stared at it for a while. He believed in the existence of the hole, but when the cave appeared in front of him, the cave experience became a little traumatic, and his body was dominated by fear and he got stuck. The cave he was looking for was right in front of him, and he thought he had come to this place with great intentions, but he looked away from the black in front of him. He looked. why did I come here for? And took a deep breath to summon up the courage. Then he turned his eyes to the hole and this time began to analyze the situation. at a T-junction, and he stopped on the spot. The purpose was to look back on his actions last time and decide which way to go. He recalled his last action, that he had walked in the hole with his left hand touching the wall, and that there was an exit as an extension of the wall. If it is the pattern, if I go to the right, the first entrance, the left should be the unknown entrance. He judged so, and turned the light to the darkness on the left. The cave on the left was similarly a deep darkness where the lights could not reach. But this time he did not hesitate and walked into the darkness. As he walked, he looked around and saw that there were depressions here and there in the wall, and blackened objects at the bottom of the recesses in the wall. He touched the object with his fingertips and felt like charcoal. If it's charcoal, wouldn't it be possible to substitute it for lighting by lighting a fire? If it is charcoal, it is natural that the ceiling will be black with smoke. He thought that the hole he entered might have been used as a chimney, a ventilation opening. So, he actually wants to light a fire, but it is impossible to light a fire with a lighter alone. I am not ready for that. It would have been helpful if he could secure the light, but he gave up lighting the fire and walked further into the hole. The cave was a gentle downward slope, and as he progressed, it gradually became a right curve. At first it was a slow step because of prudity, but from the monotony of the spectacle and the adaptation to the situation, the step became faster, and here's it single-mindedly advanced forward in a dark cave. Today's story ends. The story is updated tomorrow. Please look forward to. Please subscribe to my channel.
See you again.